Here are some local corporate headlines. Metro Pacific Investments formally files its application to delist from the Philippine Stock Exchange. In a letter to the Stock Exchange, MPIC says it hopes their common shares will be delisted by October 9th. Metro Pacific shares climbed 0.6% in Wednesday trade. On the earnings stream, Monday Nissin's consolidated revenue grows 7% to over 39 billion pesos in the first half. However, its core gross margins declined 30% in the first half due to inflation and lower volumes. The company says continued growth of its biscuits and other categories have been offset by softening demand for noodles. Monday Nissin shares slumped 2.5%. Meanwhile, SM Investments' net income jumps 32% in the first half. The group attributes this to strong shopping activities consistent with the Philippines' strong economic growth. SM shares rose 0.5%. Solaire operator Bloomberry and Resorts nearly doubles its first half net income to 6.4 billion pesos. Chairman and CEO Enrique Razon cites overall growth among its business segments. Shares of Bloomberry closed flat in today's trade. And finally, DMCI's first half bottom line drops 22% to nearly 16 billion pesos. The conglomerate cites lower coal and nickel contributions and the absence of one-time gains from land sales last year. It also suffered a one-off loss this year due to a 12 million donation to water concessionaire Maynilad and Forex losses. Despite that, DMCI shares climbed 1%.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. admits the country's debt-to-GDP ratio is worrying. According to the president, that ratio currently stands at 63%, which is 3 percentage points above the global standard. Despite his goal of bringing the ratio down to 60%, the country's sovereign debt grew to a new record of 14.15 trillion pesos at the end of June. Since assuming presidency last year, Marcos has added 1.36 trillion pesos to the national debt.
We are doing better than our neighbors, perhaps, but nonetheless, it's still something that we need to be looking at. And the way that we believe we can pull ourselves out of that debt ratio and improve that debt ratio is through growth. And that is why we are working very hard to continue with that growth trend.
Marcos made that statement during a courtesy call by the U.S. ASEAN Business Council in Malacañang. The group is conducting its annual business mission in the country, bringing with it some 30 companies. Marcos told the group he hopes that the Philippines can avail of incentives under the U.S. Inflation Reduction Act, a law which grants tax credits to accelerate the clean energy transition of some entities.
We will build the necessary infrastructure to help power a growing economy as we transition to clean and renewable energy. We all had great hopes that the transition to renewables would be easy or simple. It turns out that that's not going to be the case, and we have to be realistic in this regard.
Let's check on European markets first. They're seeing strong gains as banking stocks recover from Tuesday's shock announcement of a windfall tax from the Italian government. The German DAX and the French CAC 40 both up 1% each. As for Wall Street, futures are also pointing to a higher open for the major U.S. indices. Focus now turns to the U.S. inflation report on Thursday. Investors also eyeing more earnings reports. Entertainment giant Disney and casino operator Wynn Resort set to report after the bell. Asian markets saw another mixed trading day as China slips into deflation. The country's consumer price index fell by 0.3% in July, its first negative inflation reading in over 2 years. The Shanghai Composite fell 0.5% as the latest reading raised more questions about China's economic recovery. The South Korean KOSPI, meanwhile, outperformed, jumping by more than 1%. That's even as Seoul's unemployment rate climbed to a six-month high to 2.7% in July. Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of Sony closed flat after reporting a 31% drop in its first quarter operating profit as its movie division recorded a weak performance. Meanwhile, shares of Australia's biggest lender surged 2.5% after posting a record annual profit on the back of rising interest rates. Here at home, Philippine Stock Exchange Index picked up 0.9% as investors position ahead of the second quarter GDP data on Thursday.